Hello and greetings from Iceland, but today I'm going to talk about our most famous volcano, Hekla. And I'm also going to show you something that might just be the scariest video that has ever been shot here in Iceland. But first, let's go back in time and look at this ancient map of Iceland. The first maps of Iceland were not so accurate. They were actually terrible, but they did always get one thing right, and that was Hekla, as you can see on this photo. But during the Middle Ages, it was a widespread belief, especially in the Catholic world, that Hekla was the gateway to hell. But even so, Hekla is not the biggest volcano in Iceland, nor is it the most dangerous one, but Hekla is probably our most unpredictable volcano. Hekla is also one of our most active volcano, with over 20 eruptions in the last 1100 years. And what makes Hekla so special is the fact that she gives us very short notice before she goes off. She will, like other volcanoes, use earthquakes to tell us that something is about to happen, but within 30 minutes, she will be spewing fire and lava, so we have very short time to evacuate the region. And that can be dangerous because Hekla is a popular place for hikers, snowmobiles and such, so scientists are always on their toes when it comes to Hekla. And it is possible for you to go online and see live feed from Hekla. And I'm leaving a link in the description box to the live camera from this volcano. The only thing that we know for sure about Hekla is the fact that the longer she rests, the angrier she will be when she goes off. And that was the case in 1947 because she had 100 years to reload then. She started with a 4 kilometer long fissure, and the ash cloud from the eruption reached the height of 30 kilometers, and it took off to Europe, where our friends in Finland got some ash from us. She went on for 11 months, and she really showed her power when she sent 20 kilo lava rock flying over 30 kilometers, and that must be some kind of record. Next to Hekla are many farmlands, and around 100 farms were damaged by the eruption. Most of them are recovered, but it took a long time for many of them. But this video from 1947 is so unique, and I can add that Iceland did lose a scientist while he was filming there. A glowing rock came flying down the mountain and hit him in the chest, which was a huge blow for the small Icelandic science community back then. And as I was editing this material, I was so shocked to see how close those guys were. It's just crazy. And I was wondering, what did their boss ask them to do? Or did the mountain work as a magnet for them? In a way, I can understand those who are carrying a camera. The urge to get close to ants like this is huge, difficult to handle. I understand that. But as for the scientists who are working on this mountain, I was asking myself what is driving them forward. And I really doubt that we would put people in such jeopardy today. But as for modern times, it's been 20 years now since Hekla erupted the last time. And her pattern has changed. She is sending us smaller but more frequent eruptions. And that is actually good. It's good because the big ones, they are big, even on Icelandic scale, with some of the biggest volcanoes in the world by our doorstep. Scientists do say that the pressure in Hekla now is far greater than before the eruption in the year 2000. There are small earthquakes there every now and then, but as I said, she is unpredictable. She might go off today, or she might erupt in 100 years. It's just impossible to say when. So the only thing I can say is that we just hope that the region will be evacuated in time, because it's really not good to be up there when she rips open. As usual, I am not going to go deep into geology, but I'm leaving some links for you in the description box about this mountain. It is actually very easy to get very good information about Hekla on the web. And as usual, it is my job to try to find good footage, bring you news and information that is only available in Icelandic or hard to find. Currently, I'm working on a time-lapse video for earthquakes in Iceland in 2020, but all is quiet here in Iceland at the moment, on the surface, but it's a lot going on under the country. I did predict that we would have eruption in 2020, but it turned out to be this extremely active earthquake year, and it is not over. It's getting better here in northern Iceland, but the Reykjanes Peninsula is where the action is. Multiple magma intrusions, land rise, big earthquakes, plate movements, the whole package. That might fade out, but it might also develop into a period of unrest and frequent eruptions for the next 200-300 years. But I have made some videos about that, and they are all in my playlist about earthquakes. But this video will be a part of my channel's database for the longer future, and I hope you enjoyed the show. And until next time, I'm sending you my best regards from the volcanic island, Iceland.